YouTube, Dub Digital, Crypto News, Macro Trends. I bring back to you RSR, one of my favorite low cap gems, all the way from Huobi. We've already done some analysis on this if you guys have been following my channel. We saw that a head and shoulders pattern was forming here, as noted in the circles. Okay, I also showed a doji forming here, which is Japanese candlestick pattern that indicates a sign or earlier sign of reversal. We noted it here, all forming within a triangle pattern. That's something to keep in mind. I'm always harping on triangle patterns, guys, because it's a pattern of consolidation, but it's exactly that. Consolidation. After consolidation comes typically a bigger move, either to the downside or the upside. We need to be more mindful and seeing the structures and patterns that are forming on different time frames within these structures to see if it's a fake out. In this situation, I called bull crap fake out. I saw this great deviation and said, oh, that's getting a little too high, a little too fast. Saw the head and shoulder form and predicted a drop. Now it didn't drop as far as I thought it would. At least have a wick, at least come back and touching this golden pocket here, as you see indicated. Did not happen. We, and just so we can keep ourselves accountable here, will draw a line to represent potentially a new area of support. I'm gonna make it nice and fat so we know it's important. Okay, so yes, we had a general in the direction I anticipated, down about 20% or so. Didn't come fully down to the golden pocket. That's fine. Sometimes it doesn't work out the way you thought it would. You'll notice that the doji formed right at this intersection of the trend line to the line of resistance here. Pretty eerily similar. Cool. So now we have this line. It's a new line in the sand. Essentially, what all this move was over the last week, two, whatever, was essentially breaking through an area of resistance and performing a resistance support flip. And I'm just gonna do this because I do in every one of my videos, guys. I wanna stress it to you guys. Drying out a volume, thinning out a volume, and then a huge green candle. Have you ever seen a green candle that big? Yes, we have. February of 2020. And after February of 2020 with that monster green candle, an increase of price from that high point of like 300% occurred. It's not to say it's gonna happen again, but it's a nice thing to note and be aware of. Alright guys, so another technique that I use to help gain some understanding of what's going on is just use different time frames, right? So this is the 4 hour, but this is the daily chart, guys. Okay, so I had a prediction here, guys. It looks like we more than met the prediction. It was about 48-50%. We actually went from wick to high 70%. Okay, so this was a substantial move if you were able to wait, get in somewhere lower than this area here. And why do you wait for things to come down? Why are we greedy? Why do we want to come and get greedy when things have fallen down at a lower price and then up here? Because if you bought up here, guys, that was a 22% move. If you capture the bottom, it's hard to do so, but anywhere around here, that's more like a 70% move. So now, guys, just being patient not only reduces your risk, but it maximizes your profit should you find yourself to be in profit. Let's go on the weekly here and see what's going on. So you'll see, looks rather bullish. It looks way more bullish than the daily, way more bullish than the 4 hour. We have obvious green candles that close well above the previous levels, like what? 1, 2, 3 weeks, 4 weeks in a row. So the whole month of August has been great for RSR. We'll have to see what happens, but know this, guys, we are in complete price discovery. How far will it go? We don't know. Precedent shows that RSR has gone up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There could be potentially 2 more weeks of up for this thing. But just know, guys, this asset has shown that it goes up very high, comes down very low. Okay, this was a 40% retracement. This was a 46% retracement. So as long as you guys are hip to what's going on with this, it's all Gucci, baby. What is an asset that goes up a lot, comes down 40%? 40% is about approximately the golden pocket. It's people riding it up, selling, buying in again. Riding up, selling, buying in again. You don't do that unless you're bullish on the project. Not financial advice, y'all do your own research. But you know, on 4 hour though, I like the 4 hour, right? Because it gives us an idea, pretty granularly but without getting into the weeds, of what's going on. It's just truncated enough for me to understand throughout the day what patterns are forming. Okay, so check this out. See this chop? We have equal W-ing patterns happening here in the graph. Where have we seen that before? We've seen it here, and then there was a spike. We've seen it here, and then there was a spike. It looks like these choppy volume patterns W-ing that also mimic W-ing on the price chart typically end in a spike. That's all I gotta say about it. So guys, check it out. RSR Price Discovery. Awesome coin. Love it. Didn't come down to hit the golden pocket, but it's all good. All right, guys, that's a quick one for you on RSR. Just gotta keep you filled in. The chart continues higher. You know, the fanboys continue to pile in. RSR continues to have its awesome connections with Coinbase. But most importantly, guys, I'm Dub Digital. Crypto news, macro trends. So give me a like, comment, subscribe if you feel me. Throw out in the comments other coins you want to hear about. Dub Digital, crypto news, macro trends. Talk to y'all later. Peace.